How's it going, everybody? This is Durzo, and we are back with another speedrun of Super Hostile Sea of Flames 2. This will be my last one for a while. I got the time down pretty well. I am doing the recording in post once again, because when I did this run, I was not able to record audio. So, not a whole lot changed as far as the line goes. We will see a major difference coming up here pretty soon. This is mostly, I was actually done running this map for a little while, but somebody on Vex's thread in the Minecraft forums said, I believe it's, let's see, hi Brienne, I'm probably butchering your name, sorry, but they said they beat it in 56 minutes and 5 seconds, so, you know, I'm a competitive person a little bit, so I had to see if I could beat that. Because I felt my last run was pretty good, but there was a lot of places for improvement, so this will be the last run of this for a little while. Next up, I'm working on Spellbound Caves, so that'll be the next speed run that comes out. So right here, I'm actually completely skipping the cake and the extra sandstone. Since I took a different line, I'm taking a different line through the red wool. Since I'm not bridging all the way across anymore, I'm just jumping off and running through the TNT. It seems to be that I don't need as many blocks as I used to. So we got everything going on here. Everything went well. There was no spawns in that room. I find if that room is full of monsters, the run is pretty much kaput. I don't know, I can't. If there are monsters in that room, the run does not go well for me. But we got lucky here. And jump right into a bunch of spiders. If this is the first time you've seen one of my speedruns, the little light bulb in the corner there indicates that I have brightened up the video in post, so what you're seeing there is much brighter than what I saw. It was a lot dark. It's always a lot darker running through. So we grab the super pick, we grab the awesome sword, get rid of the annoying skeletons. And can't forget to eat. A lot of guys followed me this time. Or that might be the same one. Grab these potions. And clean up the inventory. I used to clean up the inventory over at the crypt as well as here. And I realized that it was just faster to do it all at once. This time I am hanging on to my shovel in case I cannot collect any ender pearls. Just like last time where I had to pillar up through the bottom of the black wall. And yeah, that wasn't fun without a shovel. So we're getting pretty cleanly through here. Not really much of an issue. I'm able to dodge most of the skeletons, which is nice. Speeds us all up a lot more. And we're gone. Sorry, I've been watching Cilantro a lot because I've been following his run in Spellbound Caves, so I have a tendency to want to go, and I'm gone. But that is his thing. I will not steal it as much as I can help it. Armor up. I love this armor. It's so good. And I think I figured out the use of the speed potions pretty well. I know where I'm able to use them and where I'm not, and I pretty much have it down to where I end the map with, you know, using my last speed run to make the run to the victory monument, or my last speed potion to make the run to the victory monument, which I'm pretty happy about. It's pretty efficient. Luckily there were no skeletons around right here, so I was able to make it up just fine and onto the rotten caves. It actually saved some time not having any cookies or not having to eat through there like the cake. I realized I was spending a little too much time, I think, keeping my hunger bar full in the last run, so I decided through here I was just going to go for it a little bit. And my mouse has been acting a little funny, so you'll see some weird jerky turns every now and then, because my mouse just like isn't responding to a turn. Need to get a new one, I think, but make do with what you can. Killed you with a pick. And again, I'm going with the two furnace, basically two furnaces here, because it does cook the iron much faster, so it's fully done by the time I get back from grabbing the wool. And it gets us our bucket pretty quick. That sword bench. So I do get a little reliant on getting some zombie meat in here now, whereas before with the cake I didn't have to worry about getting any food, but I don't think it's that big of a deal. I think the time we save is a lot better. So let me make it through here pretty nice. You can sprint jump off of soul sand, which will let you go pretty much the same distance as if you're sprint jumping off a normal block, but it's really hard to be accurate with that when you're being shot at by skeletons. And through here, every time I've gone through this section lately, I've been getting hit so much on the way out. For some reason, they all seem to come right out, like, at the right time there. See, I can't see any of that either, so all of a sudden, I was just being hit. I remembered my water this time, which is always nice. Bye. See, I'm collecting a little bit of meat right here so that I have some food for my way to the food box above. What is it? I don't even remember what color wool it is. I'm really bad with names. Like, honestly, this whole map I have pretty much just on memory now. It's kind of ingrained in. And while we travel here, I noticed on the forums today, when I was on there when I should have been working, but, you know, that's how work goes sometimes. People were asking, you know, why speedrun? Why run through a map that's made, you know, so fantastically and, you know, miss a lot of it? The truth is, like, I've played through this map. I've seen the whole map and I did the full playthrough, but there's also a little part of you that's like, you know, You've been killed by this map so many times, you just want to prove to it that, you know, you're the boss of it. In a ridiculous term, but mostly it's fun. It's a challenge. It makes the map even harder because it gives you an extra enemy. I mean, we already have enough enemies coming at us. You know, it's super hostile. Now it's also, you know, it's timed, so you've got to go even faster. It's even more nerve-wracking. You know, and one slip-up could be your death pretty easily. So, I don't know. I enjoy that about it. I mean, they're great maps. They're really well-designed. I mean, a good speedrun, from everything I've seen of other people's speedruns, like, if your lines can be clean where you can run through the map pretty fluidly, and I don't have to do a ton of backtracking in here, really, as much as, you know, I could have to do in a lot of other maps or things made by other people. Like, Vex lays this out very nicely, so major kudos. I would like to start trying to speedrun some of his other maps coming up here shortly. Again, like I said, I'll be doing Spellbound Caves here pretty soon, trying to take on Cilantro's record, which is kind of ridiculous. I think it's like 40 some odd minutes, so that'll be fun. I've already started, you know, trying it out, and I've been dying horribly, because a big part of this map also about, you know, speedrunning these maps is just you have to practice it and just keep getting used to what you need where, and it's not easy. It's they're tough, but it's a lot of fun. Okay, and this area is always just a little obnoxious because there's just no way to do it, you know, as quickly as you'd like. And I really should have had this on the bar already. Get into the blast resistant block. I was able to actually get over there before it spawned, I think. But, usually always one spawns. There's just not a whole lot of ways of getting around it here. And they always spawn in the hardest places, because you can't just keep going. without getting rid of them. That's why I get the bow up above there to begin with, is because you can't proceed if there's a ghast in there. You have to get rid of them. And you can't always rely on knocking their fireballs back, because they will hit the bedrock and knock you off into the lava. It's happened more times than I'd like to remember. And pillaring up like this, I think, is way faster than building the staircase. I don't know why I wasn't doing that before. And this was dumb. Just didn't have enough blocks on the bar. And not getting that second stack of glowstone actually is... It took an adjustment. I didn't have as many blocks throughout... You know, I don't have as many blocks, obviously, throughout the whole thing. So it took a little bit of a getting used to and reconfiguring what I needed where. But overall, it didn't seem to be that big of an issue. So being able to leave the blocks in the cake saved me a good, probably, at least 10 seconds, I'd say. And we are heading out. I'm always scared I'm going to miss this jump right there. But it's just so much faster to sprint through. Alright, time for real food. And you always want to eat the food that's going to open up an inventory slot first, because there's no point in eating the bread, because we're going to always have bread in the bar for the entire rest of the run, so you don't want to start eating that and leave the pork chops in the back, because it just takes up another slot. Inventory management is one of the most important things to do throughout this, and that's the reason why I take the line is because, especially like these two areas here, so is it the green wool we just got and the red wool, both take a lot of blocks. So if I tried to come here later in the map when I had more wool to carry on me all at the same time, that would be less room I could have for my potions, blocks, and anything else. Make it across the top lip here pretty nicely, actually. This is one of the cleanest runs I've had through this area in a while. I do get pelted around here a lot, like usual, but able to get up pretty nicely at least. So many explosions. And we made it through. I think I've cleaned up a lot of the jumps too. I think I've gotten the timing down a little better. Alright, so we grab torches and bread. And that's more than enough for the rest of the map. We won't even go through nearly all of that, so. And here I realize I don't have a ton of blocks on me because of not grabbing that extra thing of sandstone, so I grab some extras just in case. I saw the creeper back there, so I'm gonna put down the lava and take care of him. And I really haven't found a better way to get through here other than to just brave the skeleton fire. It's just pray they don't knock you off. Just always keep a wall behind him, you know, behind you, and keep yourself in between the skeleton and the wall, so they can't take you out. And this guy was a good shot, man. Hit me so many times. Yeah, I think I actually looked back here in a second to see where this guy is, because he's just screwing me up. I mean, look at those shots. He's hit me every single step of the way. Placed it too early. Or too high. I did it again. Spiders. Hate the spiders. But skeletons really are the most hated mob, especially doing speedruns. Skeletons are just so obnoxious. They break your strides so much. Although this is the most trouble I've ever had with spiders in this area. Okay, so here I'm just making sure I have enough blocks on the bar and praying that I have enough to make it across. And this was a bad start. This is where skeletons can really screw you up with all the knockback on them. Got rocked through there, but luckily all the explosions took out all the mobs around me. I get a little creeper party under me right here. Oh, one fell. Oh, two fell. And I'm just crossing my fingers here, just about out of blocks. There's gas, there's skeletons. But we made it. This run is always hairy, but it's so fun. Makes you feel like an action hero. You're like, yeah. Being shot at. Explosions going off. And we made it through. Pretty clean exit this time, except for getting shot again. And don't want to forget our lava. Although I really don't know if it's necessary. I just placed it on myself too, which is brilliant. You know, so there's some time wasted just for, you know, being an idiot. Zombie. Go through. Sort out the inventory a bit. Again, you're always carrying a ton of stuff on you. Getting that out of the way because I have to run through that door. Here we are off. I love some of the jumps you get to do in this map. See, right here, I made it through here pretty nicely. That was a good set of jumps through there. I was able to keep it up on this top upper shelf right here. Get rid of the skeleton. Made it through very nicely right there. I was really happy with getting out of here. It went really well, I thought. Except for all these skellies, which are kind of a pain in the butt, but we got past them alright. And this right up here is something I haven't had happen before. So I take the jump and... Oh god! Nearly gave me a heart attack. And there's one behind me too, if you can hear the arrows firing. So that was a little nerve-wracking. But I think I've got the inventory management down pretty well. This ride I used to have to throw away a ton of stuff. And once again, I will be leaving all of this in the chest right up front. I haven't checked to see if it's faster to try and go through the stone there instead of going through the glass. I'm not sure if glass breaks any faster or slower with that pick. Honestly, don't know. We are off. Yeah, right there. See, that was a situation where my mouse did not turn when I actually told it to turn. Gonna need to get a new one of those. But this was a fun run. I mean, I honestly had no idea how long it actually took me. I think I've said it before, but I don't run a timer while I actually do the run. Makes me more nervous, and I don't want to know. I'd rather complete it and then check. So at the end here, I was pretty happy, and this is the most guys I've seen in here in a while. Just coming straight in. But you do what you gotta do. See, right here, I couldn't actually see that bedrock. It's really dark for me right here. find the tunnel. I don't like how much I have to tunnel, but there's really no faster way to do it, to be perfectly honest. Like, getting through this section, you know, going actually through the front of the dungeon, would never be nearly this fast. Magenta wool. And then we're gonna go up and grab the rest of our speed potions for the map. I don't know why I picked that stuff up. It's just forced a habit of Minecraft habit. You pick up all the drops. Get away. And next up, we'll take the pillar elevator up the stairs. And it's on to the citadel. I'm actually pretty happy with the citadel run this time. It went a lot better than it has in the past. That one has been notorious for just giving me problems. It's always been the one I've had the most problems with. Just cannot get that the top wall out of there clean. And I've been getting pretty daring right here. I think I figured out how to sprint this bridge and make it over all the cheaty holes no problem now. Like, I don't even stop my sprint for the turns here. But with the way my mouse was acting up, it was actually making me really nervous to do this. And take the jump. I mean, the goal is to just get in here as fast as I can to block this off. Didn't work out too well this time, though. Kind of block myself in as much as I can. I mean, sometimes I find this map, sometimes you actually just want the creepers to come in and blow everything up and get rid of all the other guys around. Yeah, so now I'm going to this back wall here, because this is actually the wall that the wool is up against, and I'm just going straight up through the floors here. Let them blow up, doesn't matter, just keep going up. Although, unfortunately, I run out of blocks here a little earlier than I would have liked. Normally, I just take it straight to the top so I don't have to dig up like this, but it works. Just make your way down, block it off. And I've been missing... Oh, I don't know what I was doing there. And I've been missing this... this dig down right here, which is supposed to bring me out on the side of the stairs, heading down to the bottom wall. But yeah, the last couple of runs I've dropped, you know, just planted directly in the middle of the stairs, so this time I actually get the side down pretty well. And we're all prepared this time, full on food. Thought ahead. And through here we get a pretty good run too. I don't have any of the guys spawning in my face like I normally get, so made it past there without too much hassle. Grimace Iron's always a pain in the butt. It just breaks the whole flow of making it through here. Always lets guys catch up to you. And we're in, grab it and go. I found it's always faster if I can get over on this bridge right here to get over all these guys. I made a bunch of the jumps through all those holes a lot better right there. This is a little derpy right here, kind of just bouncing around. But nothing's ever going to be perfect. I was wrong, the last ones weren't the last of the speed potions. We need to grab the speed potion out of this one, too. That's all I want. Let them see. Right there. That's where creepers can actually come in handy. And this is something I haven't tried before. Instead of tunneling out, I'm actually trying to get rid of these cave spider spawners here, which makes this a heck of a lot easier to just grab the wool and run. So I think this is saving me a lot of time too, going through here this way. I was so scared of the baby spiders before that I thought I had to tunnel through. Realized it's only the two hanging out there, so it wasn't as much of a threat as I was making it out to be in my mind. Kill these guys. A lot of them came out. And this is the part I wish there was a way to speed up. I don't know. I keep trying different techniques of picking up the water and running and jumping to try and make it as fluid as possible. But, yeah, the water walking across the lava like this just takes forever. When I have to do it out to the piggy temple as well, it gets to be really annoying. Not sure if there's a faster way to do this, though. Like, and it was said on the forums today that a good speedrun takes luck, skill, and practice. And right here, this is a bit of luck right here. There are no guys in here. I've never made it in here with had no mobs in there. So that was a bit of luck right there. I didn't have to take the time to kill any of them. Lucky making it past that. Skeletons right here always make me nervous. There's a lot of cheaty lava holes. I was just trying to get over them as smoothly as I could. But yeah, for those of you that have never tried a speedrun, they're fun, but they do take a lot of practice. Like, this map I have played through, I don't even know how many times. Tonight, actually, before I completed this run, I probably had about 10 deaths, I think. Where just at random parts of the run, made some sort of mistake and ended up getting myself killed. Which, you know, in the way I'm playing here, it's basically hardcore, where if I die, I gotta start over again. So, yeah, I restarted probably about 10 times or so. So that's why when you complete one, it feels like a big accomplishment. And that was a really gutsy move right there. Shouldn't have jumped over that lava. That was dumb. I'm trying to kill this Enderman here to hopefully get a pearl for the last wool. I know the last run I was able to make it without the pearl, which was pretty sweet. But a pearl will definitely make getting into the black wool faster. And we're getting blown up as usual. I almost fell in the lava right there. There are a lot more guys in here than usual. I can't believe my armor's holding up as well as it does. Although I'm hungry here, which I really should have stopped to eat, but I realized where I was and I just went for it. And I usually end the run with so many potions as it is, that like regen and health potions, that I decided I need to use them a little more actively, take a little more risk in actually going through places and just make sure I use the potions instead of stopping to eat all the time. That's another one of those diggy, boring parts where you go straight until you hit the stone, and then you dig straight down, and you're at the wool. I haven't tested it if it actually saves you a ton more time of trying to like run it straight, but the nice thing is getting out, you don't have to worry about skeletons or spiders or anything. So that's a big bonus there. I'm just getting blown up left and right on this mat, or this run. It's Matt. Oh, almost went in the lava again. Try and get another Enderman. These guys are stingy tonight. They don't want to give me any of their stuff. And made it out pretty clean there. I'm further back than I normally am here. I just got disoriented on where I was. But luckily I actually make this jump, just barely. It's like some parkour map jumping right there. And wrong way. And once again, inventory management. The bane of the existence. There's always so much stuff to get rid of. And the spires at night. So beautiful. Except for the spiders. Yeah, for the most part, this armor is really good. I kind of ignore most things if I can help it. Like, the zombies aren't a huge deal. Spiders are a pain in the butt. Like, that gets annoying right there. Like, the actual damage is not what I'm worried about. It's about getting knocked into lava or getting pushed off of something. Alright, now this... This was a new one for me. I've never had this many creeper explosions go off in here. So race the lava here. Boom, another one. Boom, another one. Boom, another one. Like, I'm just thinking, I have no idea how I'm gonna get back. And boom, another one. This was probably the most explosions I've had going through this dungeon. And survived. But luckily, I was able to make it through. They didn't blow up my whole path through here. I unfortunately broke the wool, which I didn't mean to. And now we see what the damage is to get out. So, that's not bad. We can get through that, although we did set ourselves on fire. This one's not going to be quite as easy. I try to turn it into cobble. That doesn't work too bad either. Now we gotta run through this lava. And here I realized blocks are just better. It's faster to do that. And we're good. So that wasn't the best run I've had through that section. That section I've done much quicker before and had a lot less destructive explosions like that. But either way, we made it. We're good. Shot in the face. You guys are so obnoxious. And down the hole. So, first order is just take out that creeper spawner. It's never good. I've tried lighting it up and it's never good enough. It's easier to just take it out and be sure. I like to clean up this area and light it up to make it safe up here, because on the way back I'm going to be on the stone, this cobblestone pillar that I make straight out here, because it's easier to get up on the other end. But if it's dark up there and skeleton spawn, then it's just a nightmare, because trying to walk across this pillar on your way back being shot from below and in front of you is not fun. And there I actually dropped my shift key on accident. But we made it through not too bad. Get rid of the skeletons, because they are obnoxious. Well, and this could have gone a little better. I didn't switch to my sword fast enough. Alright, we can take this. Get rid of those guys. I do like my shortcut on the U-turn right here. Gotta get rid of this guy first. But heading through this little doorway looking hole right here makes that a lot faster. Spider. Nope. A little more inventory cleanup. And I think this is my final strength potion. Yep, and another speed as usual. Make sure I've got all my health stuff on. And I love when you can jump a spider like that. When you can make it over a spider and not get knocked back by him, it's really nice. Just keeps your momentum going. Broke some armor right there. I didn't even notice that on the first playthrough. I'm just getting rocked right here, but I'm just trying to get out. And over here I found a new quick way to get up. If you can actually get up into this corner here, dig your way in a little bit like this, it puts you right up at it, but, you know, as we've done many times before here, having a wall behind you when a skelly's shooting at you makes everything a lot nicer. So the skellies come, we take off. I love speed potions. Although they've completely ruined me on sprinting without them now. Like, it's so slow. It kills me. Path out of here isn't too bad. Made the jump, which is always important. I'm getting shot at. See, this is why I make this pillar across, because it's a lot easier to get up. Although I managed to screw it up just fine here by myself. But just think if that wasn't there. That skeleton would be shooting me the whole time I'm trying to get up. I just missed him right there. And up. Saw this guy and I was really glad it was daytime and he was no longer hostile. Got a little disoriented there, didn't realize where I was. And this is the long walk out to the piggy. I don't know how to make this faster. If anybody's got a faster way to get out there, I don't think taking the minecart is faster. I honestly have not timed it, so don't quote me on it, but the amount of time it would take to get back down there, get on the minecart, ride it all the way around, I don't know if it's faster than this or not. I don't imagine it is, but when I screw up like that here, you know, and don't get a good jump into it to keep moving forward, I mean, that eats up time too. I don't know, it's a necessary evil. That piggy temple is so far away. So at this point, I feel pretty... excuse me, choked on my drink. So at this point, I feel pretty good, actually, because both the brown and the blue wool are a breeze. There's not a problem getting either of those. Those are super simple. The black wool, really, even without an ender pearl, isn't that bad. As long as you can get over there, disable that bottom gas spawner... you're still low enough to not trigger the blaze or the gas spawners that are higher up on that pillar. So you're able to pillar up pretty quickly and get into the actual pillar. I'm using pillar a lot, but get into that pillar that the black wool is in. And once you're in there, you're pretty much good. And then you just make a mad dash out of it once you get the wool, which isn't really that bad. You can get away from it pretty quickly. So, the hardest part is actually getting back up to the portal afterwards. So this gets dark through here. I think I don't really use a whole lot of torches. I didn't feel like wasting time with them. I was feeling pretty good at this point. I felt like I had a good run going. I was moving pretty quickly. Those zombies pounding on those doors always make me jump. If you don't know, those are the doors on your way, like they're like dormitories on your way into the dungeon down there. We kind of bypassed that completely here. And once again, it's a count of 35 down from that central point where I dug down, and then 30 over or forward straight, and then just dig down until you hit the wall, and it drops you right in the edge here. And you just pillar your way back up. I think that's probably one of the easiest ones to get in this fashion. And that one, I don't even know how I figured that one out. I was flying around in creative mode and just going to all the dungeons and digging straight up to see where I ended up in the, I was just digging straight up through the lava from the fleecy box to see where I would end up, and this one just happened to be close enough to this spire here that I was able to figure out a good count for it, and that is that. But it's worked out really well. It saves a lot of time. And now we're off to Zenetha. I am a little worried here too, because I realize I don't have a whole lot of blocks. I go the wrong way here every single time. So one last inventory cleanup. Get the shovel out, because this is what we've been carrying it around for. Actually, I do have a bunch of blocks. I just remember being worried that I wasn't going to have enough blocks, but I was thinking I was going to jump after I collect the diamond here, but I realized I didn't want to risk any unnecessary damage, because I have to take a big drop to get down to the ice to get the black wool, so I didn't want to take any unnecessary damage if I didn't have to. This diamond is a ways up here. Luckily there's no ghasts around shooting at us as far as like the naturally spawned ones as of yet. And that pillar for the black wool is actually pretty high up there, so having blocks is important. And I made sure I had 9 there. Yep. Nothing would be worse than getting back with 8 diamond. So you make the jump, and I try and land on this spot right there to take a little bit less damage, hopefully. Get a regen just in case. Fill ourselves up. And it's time to take on the infamous black wool of crazy gas spawners. So this is the problem one. You want to get rid of this one as quick as possible. And I found you can actually make this. I make this almost every time. I've never been killed on my way in, I don't think. I mean, yeah, you can get a bad gas spawn right there that'll just knock you right off, which would be pretty brutal. So I do try and do it as fast as possible. The shovel makes this go a lot quicker getting up through here. The only problem that I don't like is that it fills your inventory with snowballs, which is just super obnoxious. So we're passing the gas spawners now. Getting rid of the blaze spawners. And I realize it wastes time to actually go into the fleecy box here, so I just grab what I just break it and grab what I can. Make sure I have it. And we are good. So one last thing to get, gold. Make sure I've got plenty of health on me. Get rid of those dumb snowballs. And here we go. Ugh. Ooh, it's gnarly. It's a rush every time. You just hear all of them start firing at once. So I'm trying to make a break for the water here. Fire goes out pretty quickly. And once again, freaking snowballs. So I get a little disoriented there, trying to get rid of a snowball while being shot. And this time, instead of taking the roundabout approach, I just try and go straight up here. cut out some time. I feel like I've already gone quick enough, so see what I can do. Take a bad shot right here. But and some bad placements, just like that, like holding the button down too much. I got lost there for a second. These guys suck, man. There's a lot of them. I'm just being pelted left and right. Luckily, I'm able to save myself right there. Just at the last of my cobblestone, too. The blaze hanging out over there that we're gonna avoid. I got some bad jumps through there. Now, I would take a speed potion here, but I could not remember if the speed potion actually carries over after you go through the portal. I remember people saying it didn't, but I think they were talking about SMP, so I'm not sure in single player. It's something I'll have to test out later, but at this point in the run, I was so far in, I wasn't going to risk it. So we drink it now, and I go the wrong way every freaking time. So now it's just a mad dash back. We've got everything. At least we hope we do. And it's daytime too. I think the last time I did this, it was nighttime at this point, so I know I'm ahead of my time now since it's daytime. Because I don't feel like I've gone long enough to warrant there being an extra, going through a full day cycle into night. So I'm feeling really excited at this point. I start chucking stuff as usual here, and I realize I don't want to chuck my sword like I did last time, because what if there's mobs down here? And luckily this time, that was a good decision. It's time to grab everything we left here. And don't forget the iron or the red wool, that's always important. I don't know why I'm debating on what to throw out here. It's not like I actually need those potions anymore. I thought I saw something in the corner of my eye there, but it was just the particle effect. So, gotta get the iron cooking. Not the actual cooked iron already. There we go. I think I've got the wool placement a little bit better now, where I can... I'm not fumbling around as much to grab the colors I need. As much. Still not perfect, but what can you do? Orange, magenta, light blue, yellow, lime, pink, gray, light gray. Where are you at? There you are. Light gray, cyan, purple, blue, brown, green, red, and black. We have all the wools, we're good there. Place the gold block, time to make the iron and the diamond block. Forgot to put down the workbench. Kind of fidget around with there too. I should have done that a little cleaner. Your hands get kind of shaky though by this point. You're all excited, the adrenaline's pumping. And let's see, we have iron, diamond, and time. 49 minutes and 8 seconds. Woo! I'm jumping around because I'm happy here. And I log out to check the time. So this is me logging out. And now when I come back here, I have seen what the time is. I'm very happy. I beat it. This will be the last one for a while. I got it under 50 minutes. That's pretty dang good, I think. I could probably eventually get it down to... I'd say about 45, I think, but another day. Thanks for watching, guys. See ya.